greatest love the world has known. This is the love that I give to you alone. More than the simple words I try to say, I only live to love you more each day.
Welcome, everyone, friends, family. You are all honored guests here today. And as we know, we're all here today to celebrate Seth Gunk and Liz Green and their love and commitment to one another. And this might go without saying, but we're here to celebrate love, right? That's what we're all here to do. Love organizes our large and often unpredictable world. And it really enshrines and ennobles our human experience. So that's something I want everyone to be thinking about today. The greatest gift we can bestow upon each other is to love one another freely. And today we are here for Liz and Seth to truly grant this gift to each other. We are here because we're all part of their love story. Whether you've seen it start or grow or flourish, the ups and downs, we've all seen their love continue to grow. And you are here because you are a special part of that. And you're here as a witness of their public declaration of love and commitment to one another. So now you are all part of their love story. You are here to be a part of their support system and watch their love continue to grow. So for one moment, I'd like everyone here to repeat after me, sending Liz and Seth a loud and clear signal that you are here to be witness, friend, cheerleader of their union. So I want everyone to repeat after me. Ready? Okay. Yeah!
Yeah!
And given that, we now have a reading from David Roloff.
So as I understand it, this is one of a it's from a book called The Velveteen Rabbit, which is one of Seth's childhood favorite books. That's a little tongue-in-cheek. Real isn't how you are made, said the skin horse. It's a thing that happens to you. When someone loves you for a long, long time, not just to play with, but really loves you, then you become real. Does it hurt? Asked the rabbit. Sometimes, said the skin horse, for he was always truthful. When you are real, you don't mind being hurt. Does it happen all at once, like being wound up, he asked, or bit by bit? It doesn't happen all at once, said the skin horse. You become. It takes a long time. That's why it doesn't often happen to people who break easily or have sharp edges or who have to be carefully kept. Generally, by the time you are real, most of your hair has been loved off, and your eyes drop out, and you get loose in the joints and very shabby. But these things don't matter at all, because once you are real, you can't be ugly, except to people who don't understand. Once you are real, you can't become unreal again. It lasts for always.
And now we are going to have the personal vows. You'd like to start?
Okay.
Sorry, I'm nervouser than I was earlier. Elizabeth, this is the happiest day of my life because I get to marry my best friend. Your love is inspiring to me every day. You are the kindest, most sincere, and most genuine person I've ever known. And patient, very patient, which is you're my guide and my teacher, my support and my anchor, my partner in crime and the love of my life. You're the Dolly Parton to my Kenny Loggins. During the time I've known you, you have selflessly helped me overcome what seemed like insurmountable obstacles. Encourage my personal growth and help me become the person I am today. And with you as my wife, I will continue each day to be a better person than I was the day before. I promise to give you the best of myself, to cherish you every day, and to never take your love for granted. I promise to always trust and value your opinions, and to remind myself that this argument is not the same as being right or wrong. I promise to kill any cockroaches in our apartment that Kenny's not taken care of first, and tonight the very last of everything in the fridge after you've gone to bed. I promise to try my best to realize that when you're telling me I don't have to do something, it really means I should do it without being wrong. But most importantly, I promise in good times to smile and laugh with you, to praise you and encourage you. In times of adversity and sorrow, I promise to console you, to support you, and to remind you of all the times you quoted Patrick Swayze in the movie Roadhouse by saying, pain don't hurt. I can't imagine growing old with anyone else. I am gratefuler than ever before that your love is mine and that our two lives are woven and welded together for as long as we both live.
Oh. Beat that. Seth, you are absolutely my best friend, and standing here with you now is where I always meant to end up. I didn't think I'd ever find someone like you, a man who knows how silly I am, a man I'm comfortable being silly with, a man who respects me, and even when you disagree, lets me be me. You have never once tried to stifle my wandering spirit, and for that I thank you. Sure, you laugh at me when I cry at the end of Cool Runnings, but you're laughing while you're getting up to get me a tissue. No matter where we go or how we get there, or where we end up, I promise to always be by your side. I also promise to always be ready to cook Big Mama if you ever catch a keeper fish, and to have a backup dinner plan just in case. I promise to only play Morrissey when you aren't home, and to never watch any episodes of our Netflix marathon shows without you. I promise to remember every day how lucky I am that we found each other. And I promise to grow old with you, but to never grow up with you. I love you. Now we'll have a reading from Dominic Divine Moon.
This is Union by Robert Fulghum. You've known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes, to this moment of yes, indeed, you've been making commitments in an informal way. All of those conversations that were held in a car, or over a meal, or during long walks, all those conversations that began with, when we're married, and continued with, I will, and you will, and we will. All those late night talks that included someday, and somehow, and maybe, and all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things and more are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you're about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things that we've promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it all. Every word. Look at one another and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you have been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, even teacher. For you have learned much from one another over these past few years. Shortly, you shall say a few words that will take you across a threshold of life, and things between you will never quite be the same. For after today, you shall say to the world, "This is my husband. This is my wife." And with that, we open a new chapter on their love story with their ceremonial vows. To you, Seth, take Liz, who you have promised and cherished to be your lawfully wedded wife. To you, Liz, take Seth, who you have promised to love and cherish to be your wedded husband. And if we could have the rings. And Seth will go first. Please place the ring on the left hand and repeat after me. Liz, I give you this ring as a visible symbol of my love and commitment to you. Liz, give the ring. Please place the ring on Seth's finger and repeat after me. Seth, I give you this ring as a visible symbol of my love and commitment to you.
Good job.
And now may the confidence, trust, and affection you have for each other on this day sustain you as you go forth on your journey through life and your love story. May you dwell together in peace, love, and joy. Having witnessed your vows of marriage with all who are assembled here, by the power invested in me, by the state of California and the internet, I announce with great joy that you are now husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.